known as coolant or white water, provide lubrication and cooling during the machining of metals. Exposure to metalworking fluids can cause harm to lungs and skin. Breathing in the mist generated by machining can lead to lung diseases such as occupational asthma and occupational hypersensitivity pneumonitis. The Control of Substances Hazardous to Health regulations, known as COSH, require you to prevent or minimise workers' exposure to metalworking fluid. To reduce exposure, you need control measures in place to protect workers. This video will explain how to minimise exposure to metalworking fluid mist when using computer numerically controlled machines, generally known as CNC machines. There are two key activities where workers are likely to inhale mist. When they open the enclosure doors immediately after machining, as due to the high speed CNC machines run at, they generate lots of mist. And when using handheld compressed air guns to clean components and machine surfaces. Local exhaust ventilation, or LEV, is one of the key control measures to minimise inhalation exposure. LEV should be fitted to CNC machines where operators are exposed to mist. The LEV should be designed and maintained to keep the mist inside the enclosure during machining, so air flows in rather than letting mist escape, and it should effectively extract mist. There are various types of LEV system available, including standalone systems for an individual machine, or multi-branch systems which are connected to multiple machines. Design considerations should include the volume flow rate, location of extraction points, volume and dimensions of the enclosure, and the level of mist generated from machining. These will affect the time taken for the mist to be extracted. The LEV system should either extract mist outside or, where air is recirculated back into the workshop, a suitable high-efficiency air cleaning filter should be in place. There should be an easy way to check the LEV is working, such as an airflow indicator or equivalent. Some enclosures will be open at the top, and there may be other gaps. You can retrofit additional panels to enclose the machine further, which will help contain mist and improve the effectiveness of LEV. If the doors are open before the LEV has cleared the mist from the enclosure, the operator will be exposed to very high levels of mist as it escapes or when leaning inside the machine, for example to check on a part. So you should have a time delay that's long enough for the LEV to extract the mist. So when the operator opens the doors, no mist is present in their breathing zone, which is the space within 20 to 30 centimetres of their nose and mouth. The video on using monitoring methods for metalworking fluid mist will explain how to establish the time delay. The time delay will be different for each machine as it depends on the size of the enclosure and the effectiveness of the LEV. The best way to implement the delay is to include it in the machine programme, but this won't be possible on all machines. In this case, something as simple as a timer can be used, so the operator knows the correct amount of time has passed. It's really important the LEV is kept in effective and efficient working order to make sure it continues to provide control and protect worker health. At the start of work, check for swarf or chips accumulating around the extraction point and check the airflow indicators are showing the correct airflow. Weekly, look for signs of damage to any flexible ducts and the filter housing. You should follow the supplier's advice on how to maintain the LEV system. You can also use the monitoring methods described in the videos to check LEV is operating correctly. LEV systems installed on CNC machines to control mist and fumes are required by law to be thoroughly examined and tested at least once every 14 months by a person competent to do so. You can find out more about this on the HSE LEV webpages. There's lots of guidance on the HSE website help you get LEV installed. Having an effective LEV system can protect the health of your workers, improve the working environment, and help you meet your requirements under the COSH regulations.